Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. In the previous video, you learned how to import RFT data into Petrel and analyze fluid density and type using Microsoft Excel. Today, we will focus on analyzing and determining fluid density from RFT data directly in Petrel. Let's get started. The first step is to visualize RFT data on a function window. For that, go to Home tab, in Insert Group window, select Function window. In Input pane, under Global Wheel Logs, RFT Attributes. Under attribute, choose pressure first and then measure depth. Double click on Y axis. In setting for function 1, go to axis tab. In the axis, select Y axis and go to the ranges tab and select invert. Click apply. Now you have depth increases down forward. Click OK. Now you should see three distinct groups of data points on the graph. This is the first one, the second one, third one. Click select using 2D rectangle, click on it and select using 2D, select using free hands draw. Hold the left mouse button and draw closed line around the first group of data. And then go to linear function, click it and select linear function. In the generate function and correlation statistics, rename this to yes 52, for example. Okay, yeah, it's good enough. We are going to do the same with the next group of data, but first click the circle line and from the keyboard delete it. Go to select free hands and hold and draw. Line again from the linear function. To do the correlation analysis, only one single cross plot must be visualized. Click OK. Go to input pane. And deselect gas. And now repeat linear function. Now it's okay. Let's rename this to oil. Round X axis minimum to maybe 50, and in this direction to 35. Okay. Deselect the oil and We'll do the same with the last point. Water. Where was this to 110, and this good enough. By the way, here you can see a correlation coefficient, which is r squared, and the linear function equation. Click OK, and we can delete this. Visualize all lines. Here we go. We have three lines, trend lines. Double click one of these lines, and you can see the lines equations here. This the first line has a slope of 20 almost, and second one 0.96, and the last one 0.694. Okay, we can convert this slope to pressure gradient or density, as we saw in last video. To do this, you can use any convergent tool, or you can use the Excel sheet we did as we did last video. You see, we convert a line gradient, our line slope, to pressure gradient, and to fluid gradient, and then fluid type. For more details on the Excel sheet and the related video, check the link in the video description. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content. Happy RFT analysis, and see you next video.